For the heart to perform at its best, its valves need to work properly. But imagine a door that swings both ways when it should only swing one. That's the dilemma with mitral valve prolapse. We are now looking at the inside of the heart, where the valves open and close, acting as gates that regulate the movement of blood through the heart chambers. The mitral valve sits right here between the left atrium and left ventricle. Notice that whenever the left atrium pumps, the mitral valve opens, letting blood flow into the left ventricle. But when the left ventricle pumps, the mitral valve shuts. That prevents blood from moving backwards into the atrium and forces it to move forward out to the rest of the body the way it's supposed to. But with mitral valve prolapse, the flaps of the valve become abnormally stretchy and it doesn't close properly. Worse, the valve leaflets actually get pushed backwards into the left atrium. In slow motion, you can see how blood can also get pushed back into the atrium. This is called mitral regurgitation. The heart is built so that blood should only move forward. When blood moves backwards, it forces the heart to work harder than it should. Usually, mitral valve prolapse isn't life-threatening and doesn't require treatment or lifestyle changes. But some people may need medications or surgery, especially if the prolapse causes severe regurgitation.